There are different components of a pump-out station. Knowing the system combined with proactive monitoring and maintenance can help to prevent breakdowns at your facility. Before we talk about maintenance and troubleshooting, it's important to know that there's three different types of pumps for marine sanitation purposes: diaphragm, vacuum, and peristaltic. The maintenance of peristaltic pumps will be the focus of this video. All are designed to transfer liquid from a boat to a land-based disposal facility. Performance of the different pump types will vary significantly due to pipe size, changes in pipe direction, horizontal distance, and change in vertical height. A peristaltic pump consists of a metal or fiberglass enclosure. Other components include an external hose, which connects the pump to the nozzle and handle. The nozzle assembly, which includes a sight glass, shows whether fluid is moving through the system. The ball valve opens and closes the line during pumping. When not in use, it should be left in the closed position. The nozzle tip is attached at the end. Inside the enclosure, you can see the pump, which consists of rollers that push against a flexible tube. The resulting pressure pushes the fluid out of the tube. When the tube is open, a vacuum is created to draw in fluid. The liquid or solids being pumped move through the internal hose towards the outtake lines. The plumbing for a pump-out station typically connects to onshore sewer lines or storage tanks for disposal. Other videos in these series refer to weekly, quarterly, and annual maintenance tasks, winterizing units, and troubleshooting common issues. Refer to these videos and your owner's manual before contacting your CVA coordinator to solve issues. In this section, we will review the weekly tasks that will help maintain your pump-out station and keep it functioning properly. First, do a visual inspection of the unit, starting with the enclosure. Clean and wipe down the exterior of any bird droppings, dirt, and grime. Pick up any litter, including cigarette butts or other debris. Remove any vegetation growing on or near the enclosure. Next, roll out the external hose and look for any cracking, splits, or holes. If the hose is cracked, broken, or damaged, it will reduce suction and will need to be replaced. Inspect the sight glass for cracking or damage that can lead to leakage. If you see any cracks or damage, the nozzle apparatus will need to be replaced. Check to make sure that the handle that turns the ball valve isn't broken. It should rotate easily. The ball valve should be in the closed position when not in use. Make sure that the connection between the hose and nozzle is tight and that there are no chips or splitting. Make sure that the nozzle tip is attached. Look for any cracking or wear that would prevent a good seal from developing with the opening on the boat deck. The nozzle tip should be replaced once a year. After inspecting the pump-out station, you should test the unit. To test the pump-out station, fill a 5-gallon bucket full of water. Turn the unit on. Insert the nozzle into the bucket of water. Time how long this process takes. If the pump is working at an optimal level, the bucket is emptied in about 10 seconds. A vacuum gauge can also be used to test performance. Vacuum gauges can be purchased through the marine pump manufacturers, or you can purchase the individual fittings and a gauge. Remove the nozzle and attach the test gauge. While the pump is operating, the gauge should read between 25 to 27 inches of mercury. As the pump is cycling, note whether the hour counter on the unit is changing while the unit is on. Document any issues or repairs as they are needed. Remember that keeping a maintenance log is a CVA grant requirement and also helps track the condition of your system over time to help identify recurring issues. If the pump-out system is not functioning correctly during inspection, review the troubleshooting video for solutions to common issues. If it's electrical or plumbing components, contact a licensed electrician and plumber to resolve those issues. If your pump-out cannot be put back into service right away, contact your CVA coordinator. This section will review the maintenance tasks that should be done every 3 months to help maintain your pump-out facility and keep it functioning properly. These tasks are done in addition to the weekly maintenance activities. As part of the routine visual inspection, check on the condition of the facility signage. All pump-outs and dump stations should have the Clean Vessel Act pump-out symbol displayed. The pump-out symbol is the indicator to boaters that a pump-out or dump station is present. Additional pump-out signs can be installed near the boat launch site or where other information for the facility is posted. Instructions for use should be located on the pump-out and dump stations. Check to see if signage is attached and doesn't show signs of fading. Provide a phone number on the pump-out or signs nearby so that boaters can report if the system isn't working. To look at the pump and connected plumbing, remove the external cover or enclosure. Look for any cracking, corrosion, leaking, or rust on the pump. Some models have a viewing window on the pump that can be removed. Turn the power off to the system prior to handling the rollers or flexible tube. Check on the internal flexible tube that waste moves through. The internal hose can wear out over time. In some models, this can be around 7 years or after 600 hours of use. This item can be ordered from the pump manufacturer and replaced in the field. Lubrication of the parts depend on the model. This is to keep the rollers moving over the flexible internal tube. Some pump brands require manual lubrication with a silicone lubricant using a grease gun or clean paintbrush and rag. Apply the grease along the surface of the hose and to the exposed surface of the rollers. Other brands have pump housings that are filled with a silicone oil. If the pump-out station is used year-round, lubrication can be done in the spring and fall. If the pump-out is used seasonally, lubricate once a year prior to the start of a season. Please see the user manual for your specific pump to get complete instructions on how to do this. Other monitoring tasks include inspecting the plumbing line connections from the system to the onshore facilities. Look for any damage, wear, or leaking. Document any issues you notice, the date you replace parts, and any parts that you need to purchase for repairs or to maintain supply inventory. Review the troubleshooting video for solutions to common issues. For electrical or plumbing issues, contact a licensed electrician or plumber for those areas. If your pump-out system cannot be put into service right away, notify your CVA coordinator. This section will review the maintenance tasks that should be done once or twice a year to help maintain your pump-out facility and keep it functioning properly. This is in addition to the tasks done on a weekly or quarterly basis. These activities typically ensure that the pump-outs will continue to provide a safe and usable service to boaters. For pump-outs used seasonally, this is referred to as pre-season and post-season maintenance. The frequency of this maintenance will largely depend on your site's conditions and use. Take the cover or external panel off to look at the pump and connected plumbing. Look for any cracking, corrosion, or rust. Perform a fastener check, tightening any loose nuts or bolts on the equipment. Take a current inventory of parts and replace those that are missing or breaking down, though you might be doing this throughout the year. Document any issues, the date you replaced parts, and any parts that you purchased to maintain supply inventory. Completing the inventory form will provide documentation to compare past and current conditions, prioritize repairs, and establish a programmed approach for consistent long-term maintenance and replacement. Provide copies of your maintenance and reporting logs to your CVA coordinator. Review the troubleshooting video for solutions to common issues. For electrical or plumbing issues, contact a licensed electrician or plumber for those areas. If your pump-out system cannot be put into service right away, notify your CVA coordinator. This section will review winterizing a pump-out station in preparation for the off-season. Depending on your location, consider what points in the plumbing may need extra attention to prevent freezing and broken lines. In an effort to get as much residual waste out, run water through the system for up to 30 minutes. Drain and remove anything that is connected externally, such as the nozzle apparatus and hose. Drain as much water that you can to prevent freezing. Blowing air through the system and pipe network can also help with draining. Look to the owner's manual of your pump model for additional guidance. If the pump out will be closed for a 3 to 4 month winter season instead of a brief cold snap, remove a roller off the internal flexible tube to prevent pinching. Before removing the glass and closing the rollers, disconnect the pump from the power source to make sure it is not turned on. The flexible tube can also be pulled out, and this process can be found in the pump model's manual. Check the plumbing lines that extend from the unit to onshore facilities. There may be additional connectors between the pump out that need to be drained or monitored for freezing. Working with a plumber can help to accomplish this. Taking these steps will help maintain your facility in preparation for the next boating season. In this video, we will discuss how to troubleshoot common issues that could occur with peristaltic pump-out systems. Providing a contact number for boaters to call if they encounter issues with the pump-out station is important. Boaters can report the problems to staff, which could prevent them from troubleshooting the system on their own and creating more costly repairs to a facility. If the pump-out system is not working, here are some examples of issues and some solutions that you can try. If you're finding that there is a lack of suction or it is taking a long time to pump out a 5-gallon bucket of water, start with a visual inspection of the external system. Roll the hose out and look for any holes or tears. Holes or tears are a common cause of poor suction performance. Although external suction hoses will generally last 1 to 2 years, they may need more frequent replacement if damaged. Look to make sure all fittings from the nozzle apparatus to the external hose to the pump are connected securely. Examine the rubber nozzle to see if it has collapsed at the end of the suction hose. If there are any cracks in the nozzle, this will prevent a good seal between the nozzle and boat deck fitting. Another possibility is that the internal flexible tube needs to be replaced. It can be damaged by trash or sharp objects like fishing hooks. If you find that nothing is wrong with the fittings, hose, or nozzle, it could be a clog deeper in the lines. Your next step would be to contact a licensed plumber to check if this is the case. If there is no response when pushing the on button, consider looking at the electrical and wiring connections to ensure a circuit breaker hasn't tripped or any wires have come loose. Contact a licensed electrician to deal with electrical wiring or power fluctuation issues. If these options do not help resolve the issue, contact the pump manufacturer for specific information to help with the issue. Electrical problems or deep clogs will require the assistance of licensed electricians and plumbers. Please notify your CVA coordinator as soon as possible if you're unable to get the pump-out system back in service.